Hi, everyone. It's meteorologist Justin Stapleton. Thanks for jumping on to clicktohouston.com. Let's talk about the fog that we're going to deal with again for this evening. Here's a shot down in Galveston. Unfortunately, fog stuck around there most of the day. I do think it's going to slowly move inland tonight. So just like last night, we saw some of that dense, patchy fog start to form. That'll be the case again if you're out on the roads this evening. So certainly take it easy out there. Temperature wise, we're sitting in the mid to upper 60s, and I don't think we're going to see much change in that right now. About a mile and a quarter visibility down towards Galveston. Everyone else doing okay so far, but we'll have to continue to watch. One of the reasons why it's out there is because we just have all this moisture coming in from the Gulf, and we're stuck underneath this cold front. I'll show you its location here in a second, but the setup we're watching in terms of if you're going to be traveling, all this Pacific moisture moving into this cold air that's wedged in place across the central plains and all of this pink shading that you see here across portions of Kansas and Oklahoma, that is all freezing rain, sleet, or even ice in some spots as well. So very dangerous driving conditions there. Also one of the reasons why NFL has moved back the Kansas City and Pittsburgh game to tomorrow evening. So I don't think we'll see a whole lot of showers. We'll watch this batch offshore here for the next couple of hours, but there's our front stuck. 30s and 40s on the north end of that, 60s and 70s on the south end, and not much change in the air mass either. But as we get into the end of the weekend through early next week, here's what we're watching. See this little spin here. This is an area of low pressure. Huge dip in the jet stream, too. So you have all this moisture being shot out ahead of that. And this low, as it gets closer to us, is really going to start using all of this warm, unstable air that's over top of us. And it'll come in the form of some rain, showers, and thunderstorms. So watch as it all plays out as we go in towards your Sunday evening and overnight forecast. You see the line of thunderstorms with a cold front attached to that system really starting to blow up anywhere from San Angelo across I-35 in towards the Dallas-Fort Worth area. By Monday morning, not only are we watching for this cold front sliding towards us, but also these showers and thunderstorms that will be leading out ahead of that. I think they'll start as early as late Sunday night into Monday morning through the afternoon as that front gets closer. Could see a quick moving line, but a very fast line of some intense, strong thunderstorms. These could drop anywhere from about 1 to 2 inches pretty quickly, so we'll have to keep a very close watch on that as it slides through. So let's jump in a little tighter and show you what you can expect as we go overnight tonight. Let's see the temperatures generally sitting anywhere around 60 to 63, 64 degrees. Could see a quick shower as all of the walkers and runners take off for the Houston Marathon tomorrow morning, but through the afternoon, slight chance for showers, better as you go over towards Brenham and back off towards San Antonio and Austin, for example. Then we'll keep the temperatures on the warm side once again, sitting in the mid 70s. About 1 to 2 inches area wide, might see a close quick to two as you get stuck under one of those thunderstorms. But either way, tomorrow, not the big rain chance day, only about a 20%, but it is going to be a warm and muggy start for the marathon with the temperatures in the mid 60s. So here's what we're looking at in our 10-day forecast. We're going to take our Monday afternoon forecast for those Martin Luther King Jr. parades. Will be very stormy, so keep that in mind. 76 degrees, staying in the low 70s, a couple of different systems as this front washes out attached to that, and they'll keep the stormy weather around through Thursday, drying out some for the weekend. And then another system finally moves through here Sunday, and as we peek way out into the 10-day forecast next Monday and Tuesday, might actually bring us more wintry weather as temperatures will drop back into the mid 50s. That's your forecast from right here at clicktohouston.com. Make sure you follow us on Facebook and Twitter. I'll hop on there a little later on this evening and give you an update if you're getting ready for that Houston Marathon, and get your weather anytime you need it right here at clicktohouston.com.